This is the Advanced Guitar Player Teaching on Harmony and Other Licks. It's divided into four parts, and this is part four.
And laser pickup doesn't track real good with all this light in the studio. It works better in a dark atmosphere. I'll try to cover it up with my hand while I'm playing. I'll play the Lanky Doodle for you so you can hear what it sounds like. My label and my distributors wanted me to put in a plug for the album, so I'm doing that right now. I'm going to do a couple, two or three hot solos that are on the album. Of course, all the solos are hot, recorded by excellent musicians, good Nashville pickers. And the song that's got the most plays so far is called "My Tennis Shoes Are Way Too Big." It's a silly song, and this lead that we're going to do right now is off a song called "Lawnmowers," about trying to fix lawnmowers. All the songs are funny. It's a great album. I suggest you pick it up. If they'll go ahead and roll the tape now, I'll fake along with it.
No matter how hard I kick it, I just can't get that mower to go.
Okay, I'm going to divide the lick into three basic sections. When I played on the actual album, I used a Hughes and Kefner Blues Master, which is great. I just plugged right into it, and it had a cabinetulator out on it, and it had a great studio sound. Right now, I'm using my live gear, and it's not quite the same sound I had, but I'll play the lick for you. Here it goes. Two, three. It's got a lot of hammer-ons and pull-offs on it. I'll play it slow. Two, three, four. I got is a little trill here. I'm just going down the scale with these three notes that aren't really a chord. They're just going down an F dominant scale, or a B flat major, whatever. The next song is called "Dog Named Git." I got a pretty good solo on that one. It's a funny song. And we're going to start from the solo section, and like last time, I'm just going to fake along with it.
I like him quite a bit, now there ain't no getting rid of a dog named Git. Git died a quiet, peaceful death.
Okay, this is... got some basic, it's got a basic Nashville hook line in it. This the same lick coming into it and going out, which I'll play for you in slow motion. Then going into the lick, it's got a little pick work with the fingers going. I'm jerking on on those two strings right there. The third part of the lick's the one I get asked about. It's the most difficult. I'll play the notes slow for you first, and then I'll attempt to do them up to speed. It goes something like this. Anyway, I like to put more country licks on there, but running out of time, I just want to show you one lick that I've used on a couple of the other songs. That it's a lot like what some of the Nashville pickers are doing, except I've added a little variation to it. The best thing for me to do is just play the lick for you. I've got a beat like this where I'm. Where you're going, it's hard to explain, but the downstroke is on the beat, and then I reverse and I start using an upstroke with the beat. So I kind of change my rhythm in the middle of the lick, and I'll show you what I mean. It's a pretty simple lick, but it's kind of hard to play. It's like some people will play it like this. And some people will play it. With little variations in there. But I'll start out and reverse it. I do a little bit of that pick reversing sometimes too. Like, say for example, I play a lick like this. Now, if I reverse the pick and play upstrokes on the beat, so instead of going chunka chunka chunka, I'm going yuka chunka yuka. It's like breathing in instead of breathing out. And this is no particular lick. It's not on any album that I can think of right now. I just want to get you the concept of thinking upstroke on the beat rather than downstroke. So playing the lick first with downstroke and then with upstrokes. Notice it has an extra note in it and it doesn't have that pause in the front because it gives it a different rhythm. It gives the same lick a different rhythm. So playing the lick again. So it's kind of like playing chords. Let me give you an example with just a strum. See if I'm counting the beat. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like on 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a basic principle, but I just want to gear your mind to thinking that way. And right now, I'm going to put in a plug for the album.
I never get along with the rich or elite. I'm kind of bashful about the people I meet, especially when they laugh, when they look at my feet, because my tennis shoes are way too big. With the girls I meet, I always lose. The people I meet, they just give me the blues. When they look at my feet and they laugh at my shoes, cause my tennis shoes are way too big.
Right now, I'm gonna finish up a little bit of classical guitar because we're starting to run out of time. Before I was playing my Gibson classical guitar, and now I'm playing this kind of beat around Alvarez that I take wherever I go. And I've been informed we're out of time. I wanted to show you some rolling banjo type licks and stuff and some more harmony, but we're running out of time. So you have to wait for the next video. And when I plugged my album and said all the songs were hilarious, I lied. There's one real serious song on there, and it's a real kicking, lively gospel song called I Was Nowhere Till I Found God. And at that note, I'd like to sign off with a thing called Amazing Grace. This is my little version of it. Goes something like this. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks.
Thanks for watching this video. Now, I want you to understand that just about anybody with a reasonable amount of intelligence can determine by watching my other videos on my YouTube channel that God is real, because you can't fake over 100 videos that's all miracles. You can't fake whole churches getting healed. You can't fake these street miracles. Now that should convince you that Jesus is real, and I'm here to tell you that He loves you. Now in my life there was a divine exchange. I gave up my life as a professional musician to take on His life. I died to myself to take on Jesus Christ, and you can see the fruit of it in my videos. You can see all these people getting healed, these miracles, blinded eyes opened even, and deaf ears. So I encourage you, Jesus is real and He loves you. And you can receive Jesus. All you have to do is tell people. You can receive salvation. Just say to others, say to your friends, I believe Jesus is real. And I receive Him as my salvation. I've received Him as my Savior. In doing this, you just got saved according to Romans 10, verse 9 and 10, which says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. But don't just stop there. Please, I encourage you, get baptized in Jesus' name and seek to be filled with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is good. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. You can see the fruit of it from my other videos. If you haven't watched these other videos, I encourage you to. Jesus loves you. Thanks for watching, and God bless you.